Have you been wondering why so many players are ahead of the meta and how you can master each technique that they've learned to stay on top of your game? Fortnite is a game that makes players constantly adapt to new metas, and it's why there are so many mechanics and techniques that you need to implement into your daily routine. And so whether that requires you to have the fastest fingers or, you know, quick reaction time, these mechanics will set you ahead of every player with just a little bit of practice. But your crush Tommy, where you at? Your motivation guy. That's right, I'm back. And today I'm going to show you the hardest mechanics to learn in Fortnite and how you can master them. And speaking of which, okay, our question of the day is, what is a mechanic that you think that you become so amazing with? You know, so many of you guys have been messaging me that you try everything to get better and really nothing works. And so I highly recommend Pro Guys Professional one-on-one coaching tailored to help you get better at whatever area you guys want in Fortnite. You know, our coaches are some of the top players in the world trained to help you progress as quickly as possible. So check the top right of this video or just the link down below to get started. All right, you guys ready for this? Let's get this going. All right, guys, so without a doubt, one of the hardest mechanics to master is being able to predict a player's movement and use piece control to fully control your fights. And so if you watch a lot of pro players, you may notice that piece control, and it's something that they have that the average player cannot achieve. And so knowing where and how to place each build to trap your opponent takes a lot of game sense and mechanical skill, and is why this is one of the hardest mechanics to master. So the average player is decent at boxing you up, but they have no idea what to do after. They may take peeks or just run into the box and take a 50-50 when they should be staying outside the box and trying to fully avoid taking damage by simply tricking their opponent into moving straight into their box. So a great way to learn this, man, is by free building and using maps like Raider 464 and Skavok Peace Control maps. I say this all the time on my Insta at Your Motivation Guy. You know, a great technique that is used in fights is called pre-boxing, and it's an advanced way of predicting your opponent's movements. For example, okay, so if your opponent has an opening to the left, but is fully boxed in all other angles, just simply just place a wall and a cone, which will fully trap them. Many controller players like Reed and Day show perfect uses of pre-boxing and always know how to trap their opponent and have the best aim to always win an up-close shotgun battle. So just like we said before, using the Skavok and Raider 464 piece control practice maps is going to help you guys a ton. And along with that, W King and Arena will also help you build confidence to actually use these mechanics in game. You know, we really recommend playing the Skavok piece control map for at least 30 minutes a day, as this map has over 20 scenarios that you can practice, all which will help you in both creative and in game. Fully completing this map every single day is really good for improving, and you need to start using it now. This map is way more advanced than any other piece control map that we've ever seen, and each level has its own variation that you're going to use in game. All of these drills are going to help you tremendously, guys, and after completing them daily, you're going to definitely learn some new techniques and be more consistent. And so after completing all 17 scenarios, head on over to the free build section to improve your consistency and movement. Now, real quick, make sure to check out Clix's new master course right now on ProGuides.com. We have pro coaches tailored to help you guys improve quickly. Click the link below or top right to get started today. All right, guys, so this next mechanic may seem useless, but still requires a ton of skill. It's a great way to show off a player's mechanical capabilities. One of the hardest mechanics to learn is quad editing. So quad editing is like a triple edit, except you need to place a cone and edit it like a ramp below you, and then you do the triple edit. Doing this takes lightning quick reaction time, low ping, lots of practice, and some fast fingers, by the way. Many players with zero ping can do this, but doing it consistently without struggling is very tough. You need to have the most optimal keybinds and just make sure you practice them enough and get your fingers ready for the crazy motion. You also need to make sure that you don't lose momentum while completing each quad edit, which requires you to place each build instantaneously. And so the best way of practicing quad edits and achieving proficiency in them is really by playing a lot of edit and warm-up courses and even changing your binds. All right, so the best mechanical players all have optimal binds, and here is why you guys need to switch to them. Optimal binds are key binds that allow you to move around, right? Edit and build simultaneously. This allows your mechanical skill to be at its maximum potential and really make sure that you're never going to have to lose momentum when engaging in a build battle or simply just trying to improve your overall edit speed. These keybinds are perfect for doing everything efficiently and it's definitely going to help you guys with your mechanical skill. All right, so as of now, The best way to have optimal keybinds is by putting your wall and wrap on your side mouse buttons. And so if you're interested in learning about the best optimal keybinds, you guys gotta check out our previous videos. All right, so something that almost every player overlooks as a game changing mechanic is the positioning and rotations of a certain player. You know, even though these two things aren't necessarily considered as mechanics, you still need to realize how difficult these two things are. You know, having good positioning doesn't come from playing creative or arena and comes straight from really scrimming and having a deeper understanding of the game. You know, every pro player may have the best mechanics in aim, but they would be nothing without their game sense that always sets them up in a perfect spot during each endgame. For example, many players may be scared to rotate freely and will box up edge zone just to feel safer and really make sure they don't get hit. This strategy may work with a lot of luck, but will always get you killed if the zone isn't in your favor. So instead, all right, do what every pro looks to do and always just be quick and stay ahead of the zone. Never look for tags unless you're in stack lobbies, man, and never shoot at someone that is rotating ahead of you. So by boxing up closer to the middle of the zone, you will automatically be in the next zone and also save your mats, your shields, and mobility items. Never go into the middle of a half and half zone, as the next zone will always pull to the edge. All right, so along with positioning yourself in the middle of the zone, looking ahead and analyzing your terrain will also help you maintain legendary positioning. I know you want that. For example, all right, if the zone is closing in and is close to a mountain, almost 90% of the time, you need to start heading up or you're gonna get trapped under. And so even if this first moving zone doesn't make you head up, the next zones will pull back and suffocate you. So always get up and box up on top or on the side of the mountain, as you will be able to suffocate your opponents and easily spray down at them. So block off their tops, and just by getting a single AR tag, I mean, you can easily get some kills with the storm on your side. All right, so in a water zone, you need to find the closest piece of land and rotate there early, or you're gonna be forced to use all your mats to rotate in. You know, water zones allow players to look back and beam you since you're helpless in the building department. And so by analyzing the terrain around you and just playing off of it, you're gonna win every stacked in game. Just by forcing players to stay at the edge of zone, you can get them lobby focused and have a way better chance of getting a quick refresh without using any resources at all. All right, so a mechanic in Fortnite that absolutely changes the way the game is played is sniping. I'm sure you know about this. Sniping is the only reason players don't overpeak and helps control all the sprayers that you just can't seem to get enough of. So sniping is both loved and hated, as getting sniped is basically uncontrollable. It is the worst feeling in the world. I hate it. But getting a clean headshot snipe is the best feeling that you can have playing Fortnite. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Amazing. Sniping may have some luck involved, but you know, you can't ignore the fact that so many of the best players like Thomas HD are so consistent with them. Sniping consistently purely comes from your crosshair placement, right? Ability to track your opponent and understanding bullet drop. All of these mechanics tie into sniping, and is why hitting consistent snipes is one of the hardest mechanics to learn. A sniper is something that every player or trio should be carrying, as it can change the outcome of the entire game with just one click. Practice hitting headshot snipes by using aim trainer maps like Skybox, and you know, practice taking quick shots in arena games. Like, always try tracking your opponent and never stand still for too long. Quick scoping and sniping takes a ton of skill and is easily achievable with practice. Not only is carrying a sniper a ton of fun, but constantly using them will make your crosshair placement much better and help you get free kills. Always time a sniper perfectly by shooting when a player lands after a jump, and always be patient just in case your opponent stands still. A mechanic only the pros can do consistently is upward ramp tunneling. So this mechanic is crucial when trying to get elevation in an endgame, and it helps your trio easily navigate through a congested area without having to break out of your tarp. Tarping upwards requires you to place a ramp above and below you and place walls on both sides simultaneously. This technique is something that every tarper of a trio should definitely learn, as it helps your trio gain elevation without splitting up. You know, many players who tarp make the mistake of just changing direction by placing a ramp sideways, which forces their trio to jump over and make an edit that could possibly trap them. This will get them picked off, and is why this difficult mechanic is super important to learn. The best way to practice this is by watching other players do this and practicing the mouse movements required to tarp upwards. So to recap piece control and prediction, make sure that you practice and utilize all of the creative maps. Make sure that you take your new moves and get comfortable by playing lots of arena. So to recap upward ramp tarping, make sure that you always use this tarp when trying to switch layers and gain elevation. So this tarp will definitely help your trio stick together and will take you one step closer to overtaking height. So to recap quad editing, just make sure that you put enough time into consistently practicing your timing, guys. You know, playing with new binds and even fixing up personal issues that may be affecting your gameplay. Quad editing is a skill that barely any player can master, and it's definitely why it is considered like one of the hardest mechanics in all of Fortnite. Alright, so go over sniping. Just make sure that you always carry a sniper no matter what, and if you're having trouble, review your misses and look at what you can fix. Just remember, your opponent's movement has a lot to do with your shots, so be patient. So to recap these game sense aspects of Fortnite, make sure you're always ahead of the game and never shoot at someone that is in a better position than you. Always analyze the area and POIs around you and use it to your advantage by getting into a position you know is safe and has a higher chance of pulling the next zones. All right, guys, so we really hope you guys learned each mechanic and realize the true importance of each one. Utilize Pro Guys to its fullest by using all of its resources and make sure that you put in the work that you need to succeed. And so by mastering each one of these mechanics, I mean, you could easily see yourself at the top of the leaderboards in no time. If you guys liked the video, you already know what to do. Subscribe to the channel and connect to me on my Instagram at yourmotivationguy. I believe in you guys, man. I'm rooting for you. I really am. I really want you guys to really be great, not only in this game that you love to play, which is Fortnite, but also in life. Keep going, keep grinding. I'll see you on the next one. Peace.